Wait, so Alfred Dunhill released an extreme version of Desire last year? How am I just not hearing about this? So most of us have already tried the original Desire from Alfred Dunhill. This one came out in 2000. It's an oriental woody fragrance. Mainly consists of apple, vanilla, and some woods. Real, like very syrupy sweet club scent. And so, you know, and it's not a bad scent. It's really cheap nowadays. You can find, I think I got this one for like 15 bucks. You could find 100ml bottles for around 30 bucks on eBay and pretty much any fragrance site, you know, out there. But yeah, so I went to go revisit this one last week, and I actually was looking at it for Granica just to, you know, remind myself of what was in it. And I saw that it had an extreme version. I was like, wow, I had no idea. So I looked that one up and picked up a bottle. So yeah, guys, today we're going to be talking about Dunhill Desire Extreme. So Dunhill Desire Extreme is a spicy leather fragrance released in 2017. I don't know the nose behind this fragrance, and it is an eau de toilette concentration. All right, let's take a look at the presentation. All right, so here is the box for Dunhill Desire Extreme. It has a nice black stripe down the middle. I really like the look of that. Really like the red playing on the black there. It says Desire here in silver with the white lettering here. You can feel the raised lettering on there. Has some information down here at the bottom. Nothing on top. Just a barcode on the side. A little bit of information at the bottom. Let's take a look at the bottle. So here is the bottle for Dunhill Desire Extreme. I really like this bottle. I love the color scheme it has going on here. The dark matte black on the bright red here. Has like a black kind of tube that goes down here that's holding the actual tube of the atomizer inside of it. Kind of like Dior Homme does. This has the flask look on it with a hinge here. Sort of like CH Men Privé. Really enjoy that look. I know some people don't like the look of this little arm here, the little flask top, but I really enjoy it. I think it's cool. Helps prevent losing the cap. This is plastic. I believe the original Desire was metal, silver metal, but this is a nice plastic, it feels, matte black with a nice grip on top here. Has like the diamond etching here up top. Has like a black plate at the bottom. I guess it's glued on with some information on the bottom. You can find this fragrance for around $30 online. All right, so here are the notes for Dunhill Desire Extreme. In the top, we have red orange, bergamot, and saffron. In the mid, we have clary sage and cypress. And in the base, we round things off with amber, leather, vetiver, and patchouli. So I don't know what to expect from this fragrance because I do own the original. Like I said, it is a green apple, vanilla, very sweet, almost sickly sweet fragrance. Really good for clubbing, very youthful scent. It's probably for, you know, it's so affordable and it's so sweet. I'm guessing the younger crowd probably would really like this fragrance. I don't know if it's supposed to be like more mature version, but one thing I did notice first was they took the apple out of it and they added red orange. This one's considered a spicy leather. The original was considered a oriental. So not really sure what direction it's gonna go. All right, let's take a couple of sprays. Clean hand, here we go. Atomizer's okay. The original atomizer was a lot better. Yeah, so really what I'm getting is the citrus is on top, the red orange, the bergamot, a little bit of the saffron, the leather for sure. I guess it kind of is a little bit of animalic leather because it isn't like a soft suede or like a Tuscan leather kind of leather. This is sort of an animalic leather, but it's not bad. That's the only way I can really describe this type of leather that I'm getting. Yeah, I don't really see any comparisons to this one, though. I'm not really, you know, thinking that it's reminding me. If I were to smell this on its own, I wouldn't say, oh, that reminds me of Dunhill Desire, because that one was really sweet and fruity from the apple. I mean, I guess I'm getting a little bit now that I think about it, but if I smell this by itself and someone didn't tell me the name of it and didn't tell me who made it, I would just think it's just a normal cologne that smells nice. But I wouldn't associate it with Dunhill Desire, honestly. I think maybe I'm just thinking that now because I actually know because I have both bottles right in front of me. But this isn't a bad fragrance. I actually like this. I think this is a more mature version of this, I guess, because it's not as sweet, it's not as fruity. You still get a little bit of that DNA somehow. Somehow it's in there. Yeah, this isn't a bad fragrance though. Is it blowing me away? No, it's not. It's nice though. It's very, right now I'm getting a lot of the clary sage. It's very herbally. The leather's giving a bit of a mature feel. And the citruses are kind of in the background now. Definitely an adult version of the original. If I'm going to give it anything, I'm going to say it's a more mature version of the original. It's more a refined version. This is for maybe if you liked the original Desire, but you thought it was a little too youthful for you, a little too sickly sweet, this might be better for y'all. But now I'm starting to get that DNA from the original. Pretty strong now. I'm it's not, again, not as sweet, but I'm still getting some of the DNA in there. I mean, I like this one so far. It really, like I said, it's starting to remind me of the original, so I'm starting to think, okay, maybe this is the kind of the, because the original version I did like this one, but it was just too sweet. And I'm past 35 now, and so I'm gonna I can't really wear this one all the time. I think it's still a nice fragrance, but I think this one would be more up my alley. Honestly, if I were to have to pick one, I would say I would probably pick this one because I'm getting the best of both worlds now. You know, a few minutes ago, I didn't think that it actually really smelled like it. But now that it's been a few minutes have passed, it is starting to kind of smell like the original now. It's just definitely not as sweet. And that's probably a good thing because I think a lot of us older guys, who've kind of moved past all the club scents are kind of glad this one got put out. And this one got a lot of good feedback on for Granica. So that's also good. All right, guys, well, this is going to be my scent of the evening. Going to give it a few sprays, wear it out this evening, give you guys an update shortly. Talk to you then. All right, guys, I'm back with my update for Dunhill Desire Extreme. So I've given Dunhill Desire Extreme a couple of days, a few wearings, and I like this fragrance. Yeah, so this fragrance really did start off with the original DNA. It was, you know, at first I didn't really think it did. I think it's because I tried the original before I actually shot the first video. But after smelling it a couple more times, wearing it a few more times, you do get that DNA. It's not as sickly sweet. It really is more warm, spicy, so you get a bit of that sweetness, a bit of that fruitiness, and there's some sweetness there, even without vanilla, there's still some sweetness there. There's no apple, but you still get, I guess, some of that fruitiness from some of the citrus notes. And this one, you know, quickly moves into the leather phase. It gets really spicy from the clary sage. And it also, in the dry down, it gets nice and warm from the amber. So you're kind of left with this, like, slightly animalic leather with an amber accord to, you know, mix in there. So it kind of has almost like a dry, dusty kind of spiciness to it in the dry down. But it's really nice. It smells really nice in the air. And all the notes combined really do give it this nice masculine feel. So I think it's a really good release from the house, because if you thought that the original was just too clubby and too sweet and almost too cloying to wear, I think this is definitely a good release. I think they made a good move on this one, kind of making it more mature, making it more for the older gentleman. Both fragrances have good qualities. I guess for my personal taste, I really like this one more just because, you know, I like sweet scents, but I mean, this one's really, really sweet. And Dunhill Desire Extreme is kind of what I've been looking for when it came to this brand. Longevity of this one was about 8 hours, and that's whenever it was sitting kind of close to the skin around the eighth hour, but I could still smell it pretty well on my skin. I was getting pretty good projection for the first 3 to 4 hours. So I venture to say, you know, it's a good performer. That's definitely, especially for the price, it's a pretty decent performer. I didn't spray my clothes. I sprayed my skin. I went with about 6 to 8 sprays on this one. It was very cold outside the nights that I wore this, and it worked really well in the colder weather. Overall, I'm going to have to say the Dunhill Desire Extreme is a good fragrance. It's not the greatest thing I've ever smelled. It's not my favorite in my collection. I definitely do think it's a good take on the original. I think if, you know, like I mentioned before, if you like the original, but that was a little too youthful, you know, maybe you've kind of grown out of wearing that sweet scent, this would probably be a good option to go with. I think it's a good release. It's not, again, not the best thing I've ever smelled. It's not groundbreaking, but it's good. And for $30 for 100 mil and decent performance, I definitely think it's worth at least giving it a try. All right, so those were my thoughts on Dunhill Desire Extreme. Have you tried this fragrance? Do you like it? Do you love it? Do you hate it? Let me know down in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching another video on my channel. If you like this video and want to see more videos like it, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider signing up for notifications by hitting the notification bell. That way, when I upload new videos, you'll be the first to find out. Please follow me on Instagram, $&cents. Please like, comment, subscribe. Until next video, you guys take care. Thanks.